again, no justification for the violence and the killing of innocents, but do you see, yeah, do you see any basis in that? Do you sort of see it in any from an empathetic perspective?
Personally, or
yeah,
do you want to go in a different direction? Okay,
no. I'm asking you personally, just because you've talked to these people and you've listened to them. So do you kind of see where they're coming from?
Yes and no. So I mean, for all these behaviors, I know where they come from. It's not that I'm completely shocked how, you know, where is this coming from? Again, I go back to, and this is just me, and I get in trouble with a lot of people for this. I have a lot of very left-wing friends who think I'm ridiculous. I just see, I don't think, the economic situation in the West Bank is not that bad. They think it's awful. But I see people, you're in Ramallah, forget about Ramallah, go to Bethlehem, go to Nablus, go to Jenin, people walking around shopping all the time. That's all that's all everybody's doing. Now they're shopping for Chinese crap, no offense, but most of it is not that great. But there's a lot going on. People, I see how they're kind of scrambling to get money because it's very uncertain. So that is true. It's very uncertain. But people do have more money than what I saw. Okay, I was in Egypt a long time ago, but I'm assuming nothing has changed. I saw real poverty in Egypt that, you know, like India type of poverty. No offense to Indians. But the West Bank doesn't have that kind of poverty.
Secular Jihadists is an increasingly influential podcast with much of its growing audience in Muslim-majority countries, advocating for atheists, secularists, and enlightenment thinkers. We want to reach out to more people. If we reach 500 patrons, we will be able to translate our shows into Arabic, Urdu, Persian, Bengali, Malay, Turkish, and other languages in these countries. Help us get there at patreon.com/SJME.